What's good, internet friends? We're talking about how to capture emotion in your art, and specifically three important things that will help amplify the emotion in your art. Now, I'm not gonna sit here and say that every piece of art that I've ever made is this like emotionally expressive masterpiece. I mean, look at this one, yo. But I will say that most of my serious pieces, I'm usually trying to set some type of vibe with, if you will. Now, it could be a sad vibe, like this piece over here. Or it could be a happy vibe, like this piece that I recently did. Could be trying to set a terrified, scared, nightmarish type of vibe, like this one. Or an angry vibe. Like this last piece.
Sure you're all good?
No, I'm actually not good, man.
Oh, fuck.
Can I tell you something?
Yeah, bro, yeah.
The vibe's off, man.
Vibes, bro.
The three most important things to keep in mind when trying to capture emotion in your art or amplify an emotion in your art are facial expressions and poses. Sorry, I don't know why I said it like that. Facial expressions, poses, and color. Color tones. These obviously aren't the only, important aspects when it comes to capturing emotion in your art, but if you're an artist who makes character-oriented work or character-focused work, stick around, 'cause I'm about to break it down. Let's talk about faces for a bit. Recently, I was watching this video that the Art Bros put out where they were interviewing the artist Ahmed Alduri. And I'll link them in the description so you don't have to hunt for it yourself. Don't worry, you lazy bums. They were talking to Ahmed about how he was known as the character portrait illustration guy, as you could see from his Instagram that I have up here. He went on about, his love for drawing faces. He was almost like obsessed with it just in his entire art journey. But he said something very interesting about why faces and portraits tend to be just in general more popular on social media. And I'm totally paraphrasing at this point, if you couldn't tell, but he was basically like, it's in our human nature to just connect to a face. And whether it's seeing a pretty face or an ugly face, making, an expression, it's just something that just grabs you emotionally. And that could be said about a stoic face. So imagine an overly expressive one. When I'm setting the vibe of my piece, I'm usually thinking of the emotion I want the piece to convey, or really the emotion I want to communicate through my characters. My characters are usually just subjects of what I'm feeling. And that's how I choose to communicate emotions in my art. So with facial expressions alone, you're setting the vibe of a piece. Just remember to exaggerate those facial expressions because then there'll be no doubt what's going on in the piece when you look at the face before you look at anything else. So I just went off about facial expressions, but the pose of your character also communicates a lot when it comes to their emotions. Like, are they slouched? Are they drained of all energy? Are they clenching their fist in anger? Are they tense? Like shoulders scrunched up, like are they a nerd that's just been rejected on the internet? I don't know. But all of those poses before you even add a facial expression can tell you what's going on with your character. So keep poses in your mind the same way you keep facial expressions in your mind and exaggerate the two because then the message will be clear. The emotion will be clear, if you will. Now, an equally important aspect to keep in mind when capturing emotion in your art or amplifying a current emotion in your art is color. Color tones, of course, play hand in hand with shading and lighting. All right, let's look at some examples, yo. All right, so we're looking at a piece by Ahmed Alduri, sticking to him today. I mentioned him earlier, if you've been paying attention. Aside from the fact that this piece is just fire, let's discuss his color choice. You know, we're looking at red tones here, and honestly, even if this piece didn't have any characters as subjects, the warm red colors give off this like uncertainty, like this overall danger element, trying to say vibe less, because I've said it 100 times in this video already. And then this next example, also by Ahmed, covers everything we've discussed so far. We got this like, I'm coming to get you looking pose, like this character's face just looks evil. You know, the teeth and the expression alone give us a sense of get the hell away from this guy. And now add in the fact that the painting is made up of red tones, and we know what the vibe is. Now, this third example is kind of the opposite of the last two. You know, we're looking at blue tones with subtle hints of orange, and I don't know about you guys, but I feel calm looking at this. I feel chill. The colors give off this chill vibe. And then the expression of the character is like happy and loving. It's a completely different feeling from the last two pieces. Look, these are just three things that I'm trying to be more mindful of when I'm creating new artwork. I'm on a learning journey myself, so as I learn new information, I like to share it with my fellow creative people, you know? That's kind of becoming the purpose of this channel. And if there's another, you know, method or element that you apply to your work to change the mood, change the vibe, change the emotion, or amplify an emotion that I didn't mention, because, you know, I only mentioned three things, kept this short, sweet, to the point, but if there's another one that you like to do, share it below. So you made it all the way. Think you're better than everybody? Huh? Huh? Thought there was a prize at the end? Huh? You little bitch. I'm just playing, bruh. At this point, y'all should know by now that I have a 5-question survey about how I can help you creatively. The way it works is you click the link in the description, you answer 5 questions, and then that'll help me come up with videos about how to help you with your creative woes, if you will. So share your woes with your boy. And lastly, of course, shout out to all my patrons. If you would like to become a patron, you can support me for as low as $3 a month. If you want to support me for $1 a month, you can. The perks are only available to the $3 a month and up patrons, but yeah, go check me out on Patreon. I got a couple tiers on there. You might see some exclusive stuff on there, early access to new, you know, releases and whatnot. Just go check your boy out. Till next time, friends. Peace.